Good morning. My name is Go Sugimoto from the Austrian Center for Digital Humanities. My presentation is quite simple, I must say, because I only talk about web traffic for the CLARIN websites. So please relax. Having said that, I have a lot of things to tell, and I hope I can give you some food for thought. If you're already hungry, this is today's menu. I'm going to start with why I'm doing this assessment, which is number one and number two, and then move on to actual analysis part. Then I will conclude my presentation with some recommendations. So the first one, why I'm doing this, this is a small appetizer from the European Union guideline. It says research infrastructure should have a policy defining how they regulate, grant, and support access to potential users from academia, business, industry, and public services. But we often ask the same question again and again. Who are the users? That is our enigma. There are some previous studies on the users in CLARIN. However, they have different scopes and problems. For example, some of them are too software development oriented, or sometimes subjective without statistically valid analysis. And they may focus on internal user evaluation than external one. We basically follow development cycle like this one. We plan and we do and we check and we act. But in CLARIN, do we really check our development with the users? I'm not very sure. And how about this one? This is another view of PDCA. My question here is if the development cooperate with marketing. And marketing, I mean the broadest sense. So including research, marketing research, outreach, communication and dissemination, and user engagement. But I'm also not sure either. Today's number two menu is a trend. Probably most of you are already fed up with open movement here, written here, but I'd like to propose open evaluation. I use this term for double meaning. The first one is to open up the outcome of user evaluation. And the second one is for us, CLARIN, the evaluation of CLARIN. And I put some keywords here. And the question is how to openly evaluate the research infrastructure. And following the last slide, I quote from S3 roadmap 2016. The S3 landmarks need continuous support for successful completion, operation, and upgrade in line with optimal management and maximum return of investment. So it is a central concern of the European Commission, or maybe national governments, if you like, to check the status of infrastructure. Is it worth an investment? How can we answer this question? If you look around the trend, you may find some hints for that question. This is one of the examples from the altmetrics tools, which try to measure research impact by multi-layered, measurable, and objective assessment. And I would think it can be, this kind of approach can be used also for research infrastructure. Earlier this year, Europeana opened up the statistics about web traffic, with a nice to with a nice visualization and easy to use interface. So everybody can go to this website to check how they are performing. Similarly, my previous employer, the Archives Portal Europe, recently decided to open up the statistic about the visitor information. This is the aggregator of archives for Europeana, and I did a lot of user evaluation in this project, so that's why I'm trying to present this kind of topic today. Okay, let's move on to the main dish. So to check our status and to understand our users. I'm very happy. Yesterday, I joined a session for usability and user engagement. So there are something going on. But today, we will talk about only a part of the user evaluation, which is web analytics. And we have a tool called PIVIC to record visitors. And unfortunately, I don't have statistics for the CLARIN website, but you already saw something in the previous session. So I'm more on for the technical part. And again, we don't have enough time to explain everything, so we concentrate on Virtual Language Observatory for the last 2 years in this presentation. So we can start from easy numbers. This is a basic information about unique widgets. So blue one is year one, and then yellow one is year two. As you can see, we have in the year two, 5,260 widgets, which is about 14.4 widgets per day. Maybe it's not very impressive news. And apparently, we are not doing very well right now, because we have 20% decline of the web traffic. Of course, I'm not here to embarrass somebody in this room, but to help the situation. And so we can have a look at the statistic in different ways, but this is one of the things we can do, is to check what kind of events may affect the VLO traffic. In this case, I pointed out there are CLARIN annual conference in autumn, and you can clearly see the boost of the web traffic, whereas you can also observe typical dips such as Christmas holiday and Easter holiday. And in year two, I put more interesting information. Again, CLARIN conference is one of the summits, but if you look at digital humanities conference, it didn't give us have a very big impact on VLO traffic. And this is, I don't know if you can have a look, but this is more for a technical team, which I have been working with. There are three VLO releases in this period, and however, I didn't really see a huge impact on the VLO traffic. And so as the Google indexing, which I will talk in a minute. So we have to think about a better strategy, how we can actually increase our access. And also, I have some peaks which I cannot really explain myself. And if you know some potential reasons for this peak, please let me know. So going back to Google indexing, in February this year, we sent indexing information to Google. But apparently, we had some technical issues. And somehow, Google indexer didn't like our content, didn't find our content attractive. As a result, only 37% is indexed, and that is one of the reasons why we didn't see a big impact on the traffic. from my previous experience in the archives, I witnessed about 400 to 500% rise per year when Google indexing is complete. So the impact is quite big when Google is involved, and we have to think about the remedy of this issue. This is a simple pie chart about visit duration. Apparently, I would say many users actually spend a lot of time on VLO. This is how often people visit VLO, and half of them are actually first-time visitor, but you can also see some kind of language crazy people over there, because there are 50 visits, 100 visits, or 200, or something like that. But maybe part of that freaky people might be us. I filtered the data with by our institute, ACDH, and I found out half of our users visited VLO more than 9 times. And I know the CLARIN tried to reach the member of the CLARIN, already member of the CLARIN as a target user, but it seems we have to be careful that maybe VLO is used more internally than, and not so much is happening from outside. This is another interesting statistics about the download, the number of downloads. Here we can try to identify what VLO resources are downloaded and how often. And this is interesting to actually see a segmentation of the users, because if you download something, it means they are more involved of using that resources. So which is different from the users of just browsing VLO for without a strong purpose. I also created a tag cloud for the frequency of the search keyword of VLO. This is another perspective to understand, to try to understand what users are actually looking for. And I also put the entire group, the keyword from the entire group and the keyword from, for example, user from Vienna. And this more, some keywords are more popular than others. For example, the name of languages. And although we have a language facet in VLO, and also it's interesting to see the difference, because the user group, different user group look for different information. This is, I found some interesting trend. As I told you that there is a declining trend of the unique visits. However, if you look at the number of searches in orange, you can see quite a dramatic change. And this is, I put this into context, so there are many VLO releases in this period. I couldn't really find out exactly why this happens, but this is how we can try to analyze the situation to understand why this is happening. And the same kind of information for the download, here you can also see the complete change of user behavior, because users are downloading less and less. In the previous slide, users are searching more and more. And this is also useful in order to develop software from a marketing point of view. In terms of geography, Germany is the absolute topper with more than 3,000 visits, followed by the Netherlands, Austria, and the UK. This is interesting, but generated by PVIC basically, but this geoanalysis doesn't mean a lot. Why? Because if you look at, because we know the population of each country is different. So Germany has more population than Malta, for example. So I tried to rectify the result. So if you look at the percentage of the unique visitors in the internet users, actually the winner goes to Estonia. And Germany is not really the first one. And interesting thing is you can see some other countries which you haven't noticed, such as Denmark, Norway, Slovenia, and Switzerland. So we have to be careful how we handle the data. This is another perspective. I could also plot 100 European cities on a map. And I also try to compare it with the map of the CLARIN centers, so we can see, try to see a difference and similarities. And this is also very important because we could use this kind of for strategic marketing. We can intensify our activities in the cities where there is a strong community, but also we can use, we can try to exploit the cities where CLARIN presence is not so strong. So I try to conclude my presentation with some recommendations. I think it's a good idea to do more serious user evaluation, especially outside the CLARIN people. And it's always nice to do a basic marketing analysis. And I also recommend to do more promotion and campaigns and communication strategically, because we have a tool to measure impact of different kind of events and promotions so that we know what was the situation in before and after. And I call that in, agile marketing. So every time we can do campaign and then evaluate the situation, we can improve little by little. This is a recommendation for management. I would reiterate the importance of synergy between software development and marketing. Marketing alone doesn't generate the most effective result. It has to be in tandem with technical development. And also, it is possible to create an overall strategy based on marketing research. And my last comment is that we can, why don't we consider implementing open evaluation for more measurable objective assessment and for better credibility of CLARIN. And it's, yeah, sorry, my last message is here to do something right now and not waiting for later. I could only give you a flavor of this research in the short presentation, so I would recommend to read a full paper if you'd like to know more. And besides, I have a demo session tomorrow, so if you're interested for particular statistics or something, please come. Thank you very much for your attention.
So one question, sir,
Dieter. Okay. Thank you for the very insightful analysis. I have two questions. Maybe first, coming to the indexability, I fully agree with you that it's important to attract users to have a high Google rating, basically. Now, the VLO has a few characteristics which basically go against an easy indexability. It has many pages, up to 800,000 or so. These pages are changing over time. We're harvesting 2 times a week, so things can be in flux there. And also, the number of ingoing links to these pages, since they are temporary, is of course very low. So how would you advise to counter those, say, issues for indexability to improve that?
Second question is?
Oh, and yes, the second question is about the number of downloads. So, as you might have seen over time, the visibility of the landing page of the resources has been given a more prominent location. Have you compared the number of downloads versus the clicks on the going to the original landing page in the original repository?
Well, first question is a bit hard to say something because it's a very technical issue and you are the director. So I think we should collaborate more to have a really look at how to improve the situation. It's a really technical question. The second one, actually you can really see there's a function to check the outlink in the PIVIC. So that means when users click something on the, our website to external website, it counts all these recordings. So there's a difference between download and outlinks. And again, we can investigate more of what users are actually doing for different purposes and check what is the most effective way for the users to use VLO.
I was really surprised and disturbed to hear that Google indexes only about 34% of the holdings. Is this because there's a failure at the top to index properly down into just text descriptions? And one has to do funny things? Or is there something else? Or is it a policy inside Google? Because that should really be fixed soon, no?
Well, basically, we follow the instruction of the Google indexing. There's information about how to create a sitemap of the VLO, and then we generated this automatically from our developer, and we can send it to the Google, and then we wait how they actually crawl our website, and the result was like that. I mean, disappointing, some technical errors, but we haven't really checked exactly why the users, the Google cannot index all these things, but that's one of the tickets we have in a CLARIN track bug fixing system. So that's why I'm suggesting we should investigate more to remove these problems.
I love the idea of open statistics because I'm also involved in the German side on dissemination. However, I'm a bit scared of using open statistics if the numbers are extremely low. I mean, we also have to defend our efforts in front of funders, and if we know the statistics to be low, then we cannot claim that it's brilliant. So how is so? I personally, I would like to have a way of having access to this kind of data, say a year before it's made public, so that I actually have a way of improving the statistics by marketing before I actually see that this is going out to the public and people see that this is going to be seen by funders and reviewers. So do you have any ideas on that, how this could be done and if this would be suitable?
Yeah, I think that is one of the concerns, absolutely. But maybe at least why I'm presenting this is maybe in this even within this group, people may not know about these statistics. So that's kind of first step for us to realize this is the kind of situation we can share. And then otherwise, we cannot really think about a vision or strategy for where CLARIN is going. So I would say, okay, internally, today is a good day, you know what's going on, and then move on to a further step. And on the way, I hope actually we can try to increase the visitors of VLO or CLARIN main website. So we have to work together to promote our services more and talk about it in your country. And I think that's the only way how we can try to improve. And finally, we can, maybe proudly share the statistics with the public.
So these are two things. The first question is a very short one. Do you also track the referrer header? So where do our visitors come from? There is a referrer header in the HTTP protocol, which tells me this user comes from Google, this comes from Stack Exchange, this comes from somewhere else. This is my first question. And the second thing is more a remark. It is about the geographical distribution of our users. We seem to be completely unknown in the USA and in Canada. So there is a huge market to address. And I have addressed that market a few times when there was a suitable question on Stack Exchange, and I wonder whether this is visible.
For the first question, of course, there is a recording system to record where a user comes from. So either if it's a search engine, and if it's a search engine, is it Google, or if it's a Bing or something like that. I didn't put it everything in here because this presentation is very short. And I think it's also very interesting way of analyzing the data, because if we have maybe not a Google search engine, but if users come from a particular website, that means, you know, they have some kind of advertisement, or, you know, they talk about that, talk about CLARIN. So we can find out maybe it's from CLARIN website, CLARIN partners website, but maybe outside as well. So we can check, you know, how they reach the website. And yeah, if you are interested, I can show you this tomorrow. And for the USA, yes, maybe it's not so popular, but when I look at the major cities in the world where users come from, actually I found some US cities like, I don't know, Philadelphia or something like that. So there are some users, and apparently they are interested in European languages as well. So again, I think there is a potential there, and we can try to reach a new audience there, and that's a part of, you know, marketing and the strategy of CLARIN, I think.
Did you analyze the traffic from mobile platforms, and if yes, does it make sense to develop mobile applications for VLO?
Yes, devices can be recognized with PIVIC as well, but I thought it's not very interesting for me, because most of the users actually use a desktop. So, and if you think about, for instance, using a VLO, it's not so, I don't know, comfortable to use a smartphone or something to find the resources, because they are doing some research kind of activities, and the smartphone, it's a small screen. So I think maybe, I don't know, it's not the strongest target, I would say, but we shouldn't also forget about it.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, so I have a question, and maybe I missed it, but if you go to VLO, you find a resource, and then you actually can't get it, are you able to track that?
You get it, you mean?
You know, I mean, you can't really download it in any sense. It's protected and... it's there, but it's not there. Is there any way to know whether the user is having that experience?
It's not protected. Is it in terms of copyright, or is it broken?
Yeah, copyright. You have to write a letter to get this.
Oh, not really. We can we can identify what URI people clicked, for instance.
I mean, if you can't do it, it seems to me this is an important issue. If you can do it, I'd like to know.
Maybe we can think about how to track that kind of information, but in by default, it's not so straightforward.
Yeah, I would imagine, but it seems very important to me, because
yes,
that might be one of the problems that you're facing.
Yes, I agree with you.
In fact,
you.
I'm sure
it is.
Yeah.
I think it's the similar comment on the higher number of searches to what you said. That I think it could be that just users cannot find what they're looking for, so because of increased number of records, so they keep searching and searching and searching. And so that's my explanation.
Yeah, that's one of the, my intention is also, I said that open evaluation is important, because I get some feedback, a suggestion from the audience right now, so that, you know, we can try to find out really what's happening. So this is probably my opinion, or my understanding of the analysis, but that's the reason also why it's nice to open up this information to other people, so that we get some feedback and possible reasons for what happens in VLO.
Thank you. More questions? If no, then thanks a lot for presentation and a lot of questions to you.